you can have. You can get one welcome with some local PBS. Great welcome student from Rochester High School, 16-year-old Isabelle Yee, as she sings Oh Canada.
A beautiful rendition of Oh Canada, performed by the young Isabelle Yee. She's a grade 11 student, Ross Shepherd High School. She's all about her arts. And you can tell, including the singing, she's got a bright future ahead of her. We are here in Spruce Grove, where the St. Albert Merchants are taking on the Regals. And it's a special night here at the building. It is minor hockey night. We got teams from all over Spruce Grove, the U9 Bullets, the U7 Oilers, and the U13 Cobras. The Merchants, number one in the West Division, with an outstanding record of 29-3-1. The Regals, on the other hand, looking to play spoiler tonight. They have a record of 8-24-2. Puck is dropped here at the Grant View Arena. The Merchants take control early, give it up, but to stop it at the line, they go after the puck. The Merchants do. They try to get it on net from the top of the circle. Shot, that one goes wide. Starting in net for the Regals, the young Sam Palfrey. You know he's going to get peppered from the Merchants. A battle in the corner. Regals can't get it past. Oh, big hit to start the game at the blue line. Jake Monger, the captain. He flips it up high. That's knocked down at center ice. And the Regals go for a change, giving the Merchants an opportunity to get in the offensive zone. That's what they'll do. But the Regals have some room here. That shot down. Icing waved off. And that goes right onto Cole Crozier. And he covers it up. Face off coming to the right of the Merchants goalie, Crozier. Battle for it in behind. Comes to the side. A dangerous bounce there. Crozier had to be sharp. Another big hit. Some good physicality early on, but here come the Merchants. Shot is blocked. Comes back to the point. Goes in deep. Comes in the near side, still in behind the net. On the side of the net now, Merchants control it. Battle in behind. Comes near corner. It's knocked on the half boards. Passed up to center ice. Regals looking to get something going. Puck bouncing all over the place for them. So St. Albert, they bring it around their own net. It's left there. Koopsch is there to pick it up, but he passes it back to the point, right onto the stick of Gomez. Bodies flying all over the place early on. Pass across, D to D. Regals get it to center and even further. all the way down. It's going to come back. Regals having a tough year, but they're not going to go down lightly, as you can tell early on here, taking the body. Face off is dropped, comes back to the point, up in the air, knocked down, high slot, nice block. Merchants maintain control, they pass it to the far side. Goes in the corner, and behind the red line. Merchants doing a good job maintaining the puck in the offensive zone, but the Regals just not letting them get it through the middle, keeping it along the boards. It's back to the point, shot on net. Here's an outlet pass to the Landon Koops, who is the leading scorer for the Regals this year. He has 51 points on this season. Here's a shot from the, oh, glorious chance there for the Regals to take their early lead. Regals got to finish their hits. They got to play a physical brand of hockey if they're going to have any chance in this one. But they're keeping it close early on. Nice outlet pass. Here comes Gallo. He gets hit, falls. Merchants pick it up still. Oh, nice stick there, and a race for the puck. Up first to the puck was Crozier. He's seen that the Regals might have won that race, but in the net, pulling himself out is Logan Ayers. He almost beat his man to that loose puck, and that would have been quite another opportunity for the Regals. .16:38 to play. First period, still scoreless. Mastrovic shoots that from center ice right onto Palfrey. Palfrey steers it aside, but the Merchants, they go to work. Oh, nice way to slough off that hit. Mastrovic back at the point. His shot, that deflects dangerously to the near side. It's eventually cleared out. Icing, waved off. Merchants flip that way down. That one's gonna come back. Still scoreless here at the Grand Prix Arena in Spruce Grove, Alberta, on an unseasonably warm night in the Grove. For a late January hockey game. Shot blocked. St. Albert, they break it out on the left side, absorbing that hit. Swung to the near corner. Nice back pass there. Mauger, his outlet misses everyone, and the Merchants can bring it back over the blue line. Here come the Merchants, moving the puck well. Ficka, his shot comes right to the slot. Clear it out. That one, another icing call. So both teams with some good scoring chances early on in this one. But both goaltenders staying steady. Back. Merchants have it at the point. Shot. Palfrey makes it look easy with the glove. This faceoff coming to the right of Sam Palfrey. Squirts loose to this, the near corner now. Battle. Good hard battle on these corners early on. You like to see that from the Regals. Stay on them, but that comes to the slot. Good collapse and defense there. The Regals able to get that out momentarily till it's shot back in. Palfrey has to leave that for his D-man. Goes to the corner. To the high slot. Here's an opportunity. Shot on net. That one just missed barely. Had all day. Oh, another huge hit. It's flipped up hot. And it hits the dome here at the Grand Fury Arena. So just over 5.5 gone. Still waiting on the game's opening goal. Face off to the left of Palfrey. Back to the point. Controlled by Williams. He's able to flip that out on the backhand. Shot back in. Jared Williams first to the puck. He turns. Creating some space and time. The Merchants, heavy on the forecheck. Comes to the side of the net. Regals having trouble getting it out. Once again, that one stopped. Finally, Regals able to clear that out, but just as quickly it shot right back in. Spruce Grove, they hope to get it out on the second attempt. They're able to do so, but the Merchants just relentless here. The Eagles give that puck up. It's back and forth here. Doesn't seem like anyone wants to get a rush going. Shot in, Crozier there and behind his net to stop it. Along the half boards, centered to the slot, no one home there. And the Merchants, oh nice, what an outlet pass. Puck on the left side, comes out to Providence. Providence just flips it out. Thomas back in his own zone. He lifts it high. It's tipped ahead. Logan Ayers couldn't reach it. Regrouping now. Providence shoots it in. But that was offside, delayed, so they had to clear the zone. Here come the Merchants. Up on the right side, a huge hit. Right to the middle, 2-on-2. Shot on Palfrey's glove. Looking pretty good. Officiating tonight's game are the referees and the linesmen. Shot clock reads 4-0, but I don't think that is actually correct. Here come the Regals. Hayden Rake. Oh, he gets hit off the puck. Oh, and it gets an extra one for good measure. Ramstad across. Gets the puck back. Oh, nearly got it. And he takes out Sam Palfrey. Oh, my goodness. What a collision. Palfrey hopped right back up. The player apologizing. Wow. Owen Bork, that is. Sam, thank goodness. The Regals do not actually have a backup goaltender here tonight. So it's all Palfrey. Mauger fails to get it out there. Big hit. And here comes Rake. Rake shoots that in. Goes to the far side on the half boards. Comes to the high slot. Oh, and what a massive hit. Christian DePop taking the worst of that one as he drove to the net. And the game, we're going to have our game's first penalty coming up here. It is going to the Merchants. Looks like Gage Lajanos. Lajanessi, I should say. So, Regals on the power play. It's see if they can make anything happen. It's kept in at the point. Shot back in deep. Good delay there, but nice battle. But eventually, Merchants clear it out. Monger dishing it up, has to go get it back himself, which he'll do. Dish it off to Koopsch. Landon Koopsch on the right side brings it towards the net. Crozier had to close it up and squeeze the puck. Koopsch with a burst of speed, unable to capitalize. 11:04 to play, first period, 1:18 on the power play. That ill-advised pass across the ice is intercepted and shot down. Thomas, his one-handed pass, up to the cruising rake. Rake, oh, taking a big hit as he brings the puck into the zone. Goes right back after his man. Comes to the high slot, back to the point. Thomas shoots that around. Aiden Rake on the near side with the puck. Turns, fires, blocked. Linesman, I'm going to say that one was knocked down by a high stick, it looks like. Seconds left. Opening power play. Regals bringing it hard to the net. See if they can continue to do that. Not just on the power play, but just in general, they need to play that type of game. That hard game here where they just take the body, take the puck to those hard places. And just play as much time as you can in the offensive zone, because the Merchants are the Merchants. They're the best team. Way, by far, the better team on paper. But the way it looks so far in this one, the Regals are staying with them. Regals shoot that down. Kept in at the point. Penalty over. Regal still have it. Koopsch with the backhand on net. Saved. Comes back to the point. Oh, what a tip. Glorious opportunity there for Spruce Grove. As the Merchants are back at full strength. Good stick handling there to bring the puck in. Comes to the high slot. Shot on net. That one trickles wide. Gomez has time. Puts it in deep. Shot from the circle, and that one is goes over the glass, and the whistle is blown. Merchants only losing 3 times in regulation this season. These teams will play again next weekend as the season comes to the end. Just a handful of games left for both these teams. Merchants are, you would think, one of the favorites going into the playoffs. But here in this one, we're still tied at goose eggs. Here comes Rake, surrounded by Merchants. So he just decides to shoot that in the offensive zone. It's blocked. It comes back the other way. Gomez with speed. Oh, what a move. Even better stop by Palfrey. Gomez was looking hot coming through that slot. But he got by Sam Palfrey. Backhand there. Easily turned aside. Long shot right into the glove of Crozier. Easily stopped that one. Merchants to bring it up on the left side. Good stick there by the Regals. It's flipped out. Regals shoot that out. But it's been the case many times. Regals can't get it past the red line. They get it out of their own zone. Oh, what a huge hit once again. That's got to be number 8 or 9 for the Regals. Oh, and there's another one. Bodies. They're putting their bodies on the line so far. I'd like to see if that keeps up for the Regals. Oh, it looks like it will. Merchants want to get into playoff form, and the Regals obviously don't want to get embarrassed in their own barn on minor hockey night. Cross ice pass. Well, that outlet missed its intended target. Palfrey giving it away, but luckily for him, Regals able to recover. Puck bouncing around neutral territory. Mauger backhanding it. But that one doesn't make it that far, and the Merchants bring it in. St. Albert Merchants looking to open the scoring. That one hits the side of the net. Flip goes out, fortunately for the Regals, as it was off the glass. But it's brought just into the corner once again. Back to the point. Give and go. Here comes the Merchants. Cross ice pass. Oh, what a save. Palfrey with the shoulder. Spruce Grove shoot it down the ice, so it's going to come back in their zone. Beautiful save by Sam Palfrey, getting across quickly enough to use his left shoulder to deny that one. This draw going to come to the left of Palfrey. Won by the Regals. Mauger puts it around the boards. And it's out. Koopsch up high, waiting for the puck. He takes his man out, thinking that there wasn't going to be icing, but we'll do it again. This time, to the right of Palfrey. Won by the Merchants. Flipped wide of the net by about 4 feet. That shot is blocked. Come the Regals with numbers. Oh, that was a sharp pass. Was looking for a Koops, but back the other way comes St. Albert. On the right side, Fitka shoots it. Oh, Palfrey looking really sharp in this first period. Dropped. That shot fanned on. Penalty coming up to the Merchants once again. Puck goes deep into the Merchants zone, finally touched by them, and they're going to go to their second penalty. Not sure what it was for, but we will find out. Blake Brabowski. Regals. Their second power play. Unable to capitalize on the first one. They had a couple chances though. Oh, huge hit. Puck eventually cleared onto Palfrey. He leaves it for the captain, Mauger. Mauger bringing it up. Call on that penalty. It was a cross check. Regals will take it. Puck goes on to the side of the net. Crozier covers it up. .427 left to play. First period. Regals got to be pleased with their game. And if we're being honest, Sam Palfrey having a hell of a game. Longer unable to keep that puck in. Dishes it up. Cross ice pass. Goes in deep. Regals got to go to work. That they do. They're able to regain the puck. Longer. Cross ice. At the top of the circle. Shot on net. Bounces onto Crozier and then goes into the corner and is cleared out. Less than a minute to play in this power play. Gotta be quick as merchants were changing. Regals now getting some new troops on the ice. The puck goes right onto Crozier harmlessly. He'll cover it up. Off coming to the right of Crozier. 34 to play on the power play. Back to the point. Point to point. A dribbler right in front. Regals unable to get that rebound on Crozier in time. Merchants. They cleared it, but Regals have a few more seconds left on this power play to gain the offensive zone. They flip it to the slot. No one there. That clearing attempt initially knocked down, but does come out. Merchants about to get their fifth man back on the ice. And they're at even strength, and there's an opportunity for the Regals there. Crozier denying that. Puck comes up high, knocked down, bouncing in the slot, and backhanded by Providence onto Crozier. And Crozier says enough is enough. Merchants killing off a second penalty there to keep this game tied. 2:39 to play. Merchants have it in their own zone. Comes around to the near side. Gomez unable to get it out. Swings it back in deep. And it eventually comes out. Williams with the puck in his own territory. Absorbs a hit, moves it around. But the puck is given away. The merchants have it, but they can't get a shot on net. So the Regals up on the right side of the ice, they shoot it, but that one's deflected, goes high and into the netting. Less than two to play. First period. Story of the first thus far. Sam Palfrey. And the Regals' inability to capitalize on their two-man advantages. They had a few chances, but unable to beat Crozier. Here's a chance. It's fun. What a goal. A cross ice pass. Palfrey was sprawled out. He had no chance on that one. And the Merchants open the scoring late in the first period. That's Mateo Gallo getting the pass. And it was wide open. Had all day. And he's not going to miss that one. That goal coming. Oh, and there's another opportunity for the Merchants to hit their second already. Here they come, coming from the corner. Shot on net. There's the far side. Regals move it out of their own zone. That shot, nice pad save there by Crozier. Goes into the corner, big hit. Providence knocking that puck loose. But the Merchants able to get it out, and here's another chance for Gallo. Shot, scores! Had all the time in the world. And with just a minute two left to play in the second period, sorry, the first period, the Merchants get their second goal. This time it's Nico Gallo. Gallo getting his 56th point of the season. Taking the scoring lead for the Merchants with that one. So the Regals, all of a sudden, after playing pretty well in comparison to the Merchants for the first 18 minutes of this first period, they find themselves down by two. Battle along the half boards. Comes to center ice. Merchants content with just shooting that back in to the offensive zone. 30 seconds remain. Puck up for grabs along the boards. Regals shoot that out. Only comes to center ice. But the play is called on the offside as one of the Merchants players was still in the zone. 18 seconds. Neutral zone face-off. Here comes Koops. Tries to bring it up the middle. Comes back to the point, but it squeaks out. 6 seconds left. Bork has to be quick. Shot on net. That one looks like Palfrey was able to put his pad out. So after one period, score is 2-0 Merchants. Stay tuned for the rest of the game here on Minor Hockey Night. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Grant Fuhr Arena, where the St. Albert Merchants have a 2-0 lead over the Spruce Grove Regals. Mateo Gallo scoring, as well as Nico Gallo late in that first period to take this lead. The Regals playing with the Merchants for the majority of that period. Regals got bailed out by their goaltender Sam Palfrey on multiple occasions to keep it in such a tight game. They pick up right where they left off by taking the body and staying physical. Longer, battling. Regals bring that out on the left side, over the blue line. Put it in deep. No one there but Merchants. Comes back to the point, shot goes wide. Looking for the tip, Rake wasn't able to hit it with the stick. So, gives the Merchants the opportunity to bring it out. They have room. Put it in deep. Merchants on the attack. Puck it back at the point. Kept in by Stevenson. Swatted out by Rake. Here's a 2-on-1. 2-on-2 now. Shot from distance by Cade Cron. And it is swallowed up by Cole Crozier. Had a discussion with Sean Moore, the Regals head coach, over the intermission, and he liked the physicality that the boys brought out, but a couple breakdowns at the end causing them to be down by a couple. Face off to the right of Crozier. Put around to the near side. It's flipped up high. hits a stanchion and comes down. So we're gonna have a neutral zone face off. Regals getting the right personnel on the ice. Laschuk shoots that in deep. Goes on to Crozier. Crozier stomps that. Comes back out. Williams puts that up high. Here come the Regals. Pass back to Hiller. Go to Kron. Kron trying to find Kupsch. Unable to do so. Nice stick there by Landon Kupsch. But the Merchants able to regroup, get it out. Carlson passes it back. That shot on Palfrey. He stops it. Puck was still loose. The referee blows it dead. Face off to the right of Sam Palfrey. He's gonna have to stay sharp. The Regals want to stay in this game. Puck swung around, kept in. Here's the Merchants at the high slot. But the Regals able to regroup. Hayden Rake shoots that in. Going to work. But that one's flipped up and out of play. So just over 2 minutes gone in the second period. Score remains 2-0 in favor of the Merchants. St. Albert, they win that face-off. But the Regals still battling. They get the puck. There's a chance right there. Providence unable to get his stick on it, or else it would have been a tap-in goal. Here comes Saunders. Saunders, his cross-ice pass. That's disrupted. Merchants still on the forecheck. And they pick up the puck. It's in deep. Battle for it. Comes to the near side. Back to the point. Jeffrey, his shot. It doesn't make it on. Merchants. Oh, what a save, Palfrey. His best of the night. Coming over. Getting a glove on it. Made numerous glove saves. That one. The best. Nevertheless, the Regals, they get it out. Here comes Providence through the middle. Good hard to the net. Providence brings it all the way up, right to the net himself. Gets a good opportunity, but Crozier able to shut the door. Puck is dropped. Regals win it. That shot. Nice save, Crozier. Regals still battling along the half boards, but that one's chopped up high and hits the netting. Face off. Coming back to the neutral zone. Controlled by Spruce Grove. West laying a hit, separating man from puck. And ultimately it comes all the way down. Palfrey has to handle it. Burrows losing the puck. Giving them another golden opportunity for the Merchants. He was looking to break out here though. Up on the left side. They shoot it in deep. My goodness, Merchants all over the ice. Burrows passes it over. Berthume shot goes wide and comes all the way down. Up on the right side, shot for the Merchants. That one doesn't make it on its intended target. Bork absorbs a hit. Ramstad dishing it off. Nice save, Palfrey. Big collisions all over the ice. Shot back in. And Burrows with speed around his own net. Passes it off, gets it back up on the left side over the blue line. His shot deflected. And once again, it's out of play. This draw coming to the right of Crozier, won by the Merchants. Regals on the forecheck and it ends up on the side of the net, and Crozier had no choice but to cover it up. Face up to the right of Crozier. Regals doing decently well in the face-off circle. That shot easily handled by the Merchants goaltender. Another offensive zone draw for Spruce Grove. Puck up for grabs. Koops keeps that in, puts it into the corner. Goes around to the near side. Back in behind. Battle for it. Comes loose. It's backhanded. Not quite out yet. St. Albert, what giveaway there. Right in the slot. Koops, it's a goal! Koops just throws it on net from the backhand and somehow it bounces past Crozier. And that's exactly what Spruce Grove needs. Landon Koops with his 33rd of the year and 52nd point. That goal with 5:23 gone in the second period. And that's huge for Spruce Grove if they want to stay with the Merchants. Now they have a chance. There's a giveaway in the defensive zone, giving the Regals an opportunity to tie it up. Shot from distance, scores! Last chuck, throws it on net, and Koops tips it home. So less than 30 seconds after getting their first goal, the Regals are able to tie it up and we have a brand new game. It's Koops' 34th goal and 53rd point. He's dumped in deep. West, first back, first one to the puck. So it's going to come back on the icing. Landon Koops able to tip that shot home. Past Crozier. And it is 2-2 here at the Grant Fuhr Arena. Quite the crowd here tonight as well, as it's minor hockey week. Here comes Koops, looking for a third. Centering the puck. High slot, scores! The Regals are feeling it now. A good passing play in the offensive zone off the rush, and Cade Cron puts it home. All of this coming in less than a minute. The three goals for the Regals, and the Merchants forced to take a timeout to regroup. Did not see this coming. So the Regals have an outside chance of making the playoffs if they win the rest of their games and they get some help. It is mathematically possible for them to make the playoffs, but it all starts here and they have the lead for the first time tonight after scoring 3 goals against the Merchants in less than 1 minute. Landon Koops with a couple, and Cade Cron with the third. Merchants back in their own zone. Passing it up on the right side. Merchants bring it back into the slot. They look rejuvenated after that timeout. As you think they would. Puck bouncing around on the crease. Palfrey on his behind. Puck underneath him. Looks like it was still loose. But all the players converging, battling right there. Palfrey going for a skate. Some end-to-end action early on in the second period. Faceoff coming to the right of Palfrey. What will we see next here in the Grove? Merchants have it on the right side. That shot steered aside. Good battle for a loose puck along the half boards. Merchants have it. It's a shot. That one just goes wide. Palfrey flopping around, gets up. And the Regals able to finally get that out. Merchants back on the forecheck, taking the body. Battle in the defensive zone there for the Regals in front of the referee. Cooler heads prevail. Merchants bring that over the blue line on the right side, bring it up in deep. Around the offensive zone, Jeffrey at the point, cross ice, shot on net. That was a howitzer, that one just over the cage. And now there's going to be a penalty coming up. Another cross check. Oh, and some extracurricular activity as well. Both these teams fired up. But the Regals going to go to the box for the first time tonight. Cross check being called. Mason Osenchuk, the culprit. So the Merchants to the power play. Their first of the night. Looking to tie it up at 3. Gomez passing it off. Stevenson back to Gomez. Gomez on the far side. That shot handled by Palfrey. Merchant still on the attack. They pass it back. Gomez stick handling, looking for a pass. Finds one. Puck goes into the corner. And a good battle there. Got 3 Merchants and a couple Regals. Finally comes loose. Merchants have it at the point. Good stick handling here by Gomez. Dishing it across. Nice block. Excellent block by Cade Cron, preventing that pass. That shot goes over the cage. Merchants unable to keep it in there, and it comes all the way down. Less than a minute on this opening power play for St. Albert. And bring it up over the middle. Stopping, pivoting, give and go. One time, nice pad save by Palfrey. Read that all the way. Another pass across the ice. Merchants threatening here. Shot. Oh, giving up the body. What a beautiful block. That was Nick Taylor Burrows getting down low. You can tell he's in some pain. But still out there. Another block. This time blocked by Mulger. Regals selling out here, helping out their goaltender. Puck goes up in the air into the corner, but back to the slot. And the Regals able to kill that penalty. There's a shot. Ostenchuk came out of the box, but unable to get it on net. Williams, Dublin back to into his own zone. Last Chuck flipped it up, gave it away. Here's Gallo, his shot. Palfrey got a piece of that one. Merchant's been going glove side for a lot of these grade A scoring chances, but Sam Palfrey has had plenty of answers. Merchants bring that up through the middle. Shot off the post. Right from the high slot. It was that close to being 3-3. That clearing attempt is fanned on. It's Logan Ayers. Flips it off the boards. Too high. Too much weight on it. So it's going to come back on the icing. So with 9:22 to play in the second period, the Regals hold a 3-2 lead. After giving up two late in the first period, they score three within a minute. Merchants point to point. Good shot. Palfrey says nope. Just takes out his glove, gets the whistle. Off in the offensive zone for the Merchants. Puck goes to the far corner, whipped around to the near side. Good stick there by Laschuk. He's back into the defensive zone. First to it is Williams, and he whips it around. And Providence gets stopped by the referee, or else he probably would have had a break towards a net. Referee hearing it from the bench, obviously. So after all is said and done, faceoff's going to come to the right of Sam Palfrey. The referees are just trying to get the right people on the ice. Things getting heated here. Referees hearing it from the fans. Minor hockey week. Minor hockey night, I should say. Here tonight at the Grand Prix Arena, like I mentioned before. It's a great thing what the Regals do, putting on events like this. Had a frisbee toss during the intermission. So they got everything figured out. Puck is dropped. Jeffrey at the point. Comes the slot. Not on net. Instead, to the center ice. Carlson, his pass across. It's disrupted by Williams. And Providence has it in the offensive zone. Puck was bouncing around, unable to do anything with it. Gomez, good move to gain the offensive zone. Oh, here's a chance. What a save, Palfrey, another one. Palfrey standing on his head tonight. Comes Laschuk. He flips it in. Going to work are the Regals. Puck in behind the net. Oh, nice hit. Here's a chance. Thomas. Oh, and it goes off his stick. He had all the time in the world in this slot. And it just he just loses control at the last minute. And it stays 3-2. There's a long shot right into the glove. Crozier decides to hold on to it. So we got 7:37 to play. The physicality is still a major factor here. Both teams not wanting to give up an inch. Back to the point, shot on net. Oh, and that one just whistles wide, had some steam on it. Comes last, Koopsch, landing Koopsch, puts it in. Battle along the half boards, comes to the circle, and here's a break for Gallo. Gallo all alone, scores! The speedy Gallo, able to get his second of the game, and we're tied at three. Nico Gallo had a break from center ice. Palfrey came out to challenge him. Got deked out. So another tie hockey game here. Puck came on to Crozier and just covers it up. So there's some discussion. There's also equipment on the ice. Ryan DeTema's glove. Some ice on it. DeTema taking the draw. Merchants win it. They look to get it out. Oh, there's some more physical play in the neutral zone. Gallo with it. Nice move. To the boards of net. Comes loose. Back to the high slot. Left circle. Shot on net. Goes up in the air. Palfrey stops it. Finds it. Gloves it. Sail line changes for both these teams. Face up to the right of Palfrey. One by the Merchants. Good block there by Providence. Puck goes into the corner around the net to the far side. Stick handling. And give away there. Regals bring it over into the offensive zone, only momentarily, and puck comes back to the other way. There's a chance. That one unable to make it towards the net. It's cleared out. A race for the puck. Good speed there by Ayers. Goes right onto Crozier, and Crozier gets the whistle. 6 minutes left. An entertaining second period. Let's face off to the right of Crozier. Back at the point, shot on net, just missing. Merchants, their clearing attempt is going to result in an icing, even though the first player to the puck was a Merchant. Of Stevenson just flying at full speed. So the Regals are going to have an offensive zone drone draw here, and it's up the grabs. Landon Koops puts it deep. Comes to the side of the net. It's in! Oh, it's waving off. Referee's waving it off. And a scrum ensues at the side of the net. That was a weird play as it was just thrown from a sharp angle. Regals thought it was in. Referee immediately waved it off. Referee says no goal. Crozier has the puck in his glove. And yeah, so after all the mayhem, faceoff coming to the neutral zone, Sean Moore looking for an explanation. All of this coming with 5:43 and this tight hockey game. Shots 23-21 in favor of the Merchants. Moore getting a lengthy explanation. Nope, finally the puck is dropped. St. Albert wins that draw. Here they come. Oh no, it was touched by a hand pass, giving the Regals an opportunity to bring it up. Williams unable to bring it all the way towards the net, and they're forced to clear. The Regals are. Merchants have some room. They put it off the boards. And with numbers, here come the Merchants up on the right side. Stopping, pivoting, where is it? It's bouncing around, goes into the corner. Big howitzer, missed by a mile. Cleared out. Merchants regrouping at center ice. Shot right back in. Oh, tricky bounce there. Palfrey staying sharp. Exactly 5 minutes to play in this middle period. Face off coming to the right of Sam. Thomas backhands it around. On the right left side now for the Regals. But the Regals having trouble getting it out. And the Merchants looking to take advantage here. Gallo shot. That one goes off a stick. And over the glass. Another offensive zone draw for St. Albert. Puck bouncing around, up for grabs, shot in deep. Put around to the far side, stopped. Kept in. St. Albert on the forecheck. Regained possession of the puck, point to point, give and go, shot. That one just tipped wide. Regals flip that high and it's out. Merchants regrouping in their own zone. That pass goes off a stick and hits the dome here at the Grant Fuhr Arena. It's face off coming in the neutral zone. Merchants looking to bring it in but can't. Good defense there by Spruce Grove. They flip that out but back the other way. Merchants come up on the right side. That shot goes into the corner. The Eagles just get that to center. That's as far as it'll go and back the other way. Once again the Merchants just stopping the Regals from getting it past the red line. And they're on the attack, but a giveaway there. Regals, see if they can get it past the red line this time. No, they cannot. Fucking deep. behind the net. There's a chance. Oh, nice save, Palfrey, as he comes out of his crease to stop that one, challenging the shooter. Koops with some moves. Tries to tuck it in. The puck was just laying there momentarily, but the Merchants able to get away from that, and they bring it up. Here's a shot right into the glove of Palfrey. Chances for both teams on that sequence. Less than three to play. Tie hockey game. Period number two. Regals need to win this game to keep their season alive if they want to have any sort of chance of making the playoffs. On the other side, the Merchants have only lost three games all year in regulation. This has been a good one. Maybe one of the, probably one of the Regals' best games of the season, being able to stay with a team of this caliber. That shot is blocked. That one is saved by the right pad of Palfrey. Big hit there as the puck comes out. Oh, I don't know what was going on there. Merchant's player didn't lost control of the puck, but in a fashion that you don't normally see. There's a chance. Oh, goes on to Palfrey. Oh, no, nice big, huge block there. The Eagles selling out their defenders as far as blocking shots, getting those areas, putting their body on the line. They realize that their goalie has bailed them out plenty of times. He might have to do so again here. That shot goes far on the blocker side. Providence there to pick it up, dishing it off. Williams, his hard shot blockered into the corner. Merchants bring that out through the middle. Up for grabs. Back and forth they go. It's Jared Williams with the puck. Puts it in the corner. But St. Albert, they have it over the red line. On the right wing, stop and pivoting, centering, nobody there. Here's Thomas, dishing it off to Koops. Koops, already scoring twice in the second period. There's a chance, Crozier there, when Koops is taking his man out. 54.5 left. Regals gonna have an offensive zone draw. You know what they're thinking. How huge would it be to go to the third period with the lead against the league's top team? Merchants have it. They're just content with bouncing it off the boards. Landon Koops all over the ice tonight. Here's West. He puts it across the ice, but it goes back into the defensive zone. Merchants regrouping. Here come the Merchants on the left side, along the half boards. That shot missed by 3 feet, and it's out. Here comes a penalty. This time it's to Rimstad for slashing. So there's only 11 seconds remaining in the second period, but the Regals going to another power play. And as they look to take the lead once again, puck is dropped. Up for grabs. Who wants it? St. Albert able to clear it out. So that will pretty much do it for period number two, a very, very entertaining period. After 40 minutes, the score is 3-3 here on Minor Hockey Night at the Grand Fury Arena. Stay tuned for the third. We are back here in Spruce Grove, Alberta, where we have quite the hockey game between the Merchants and the Regals. After 40 minutes, the score is 3-3, been back and forth. Regals scoring three goals in under a minute in that second period. Merchants responded after scoring on a breakaway. So it's anyone's hockey game tonight. Referee takes a tumble. Fans love it. Merchants, 59 points on the year. Regals, only 18 in comparison. However, Regals have an outside chance of making the playoffs still. Opening draw in the third period, controlled by the Spruce Grove Regals. Cross ice pass. Comes back into the defensive zone. Jake Mauger, the captain for the Regals, picks it up. Dishes it up. Landon Koops unable to bring it in, so Regals have to regroup. Some miscommunication by the Regals, forcing them back in their own zone. Here comes Koops, the leading scorer for the Regals. Brought it all the way. Shot on net. That's denied. Hayden Rake gets it out of the zone. Koops dishes it off. Point to point. Thomas puts it in deep. That's whipped around and it's going to come all the way down on this fresh sheet of ice. Palfrey with a dangerous pass there. Thomas skating for it, picking it up, passing it back. The Eagles look to break out here. That's exactly what they'll do. Partial 3-on-2. That shot, attempt, goes into the corner in behind the net. Battle for the puck. The Eagles have it. Shot, rebound. That one just misses. There's some interference there and some rough stuff away from the play. And finally the whistle is blown. And we'll see if any penalties have been called here. It's like the only person going towards the sin bin is Hayden Rake. So the Merchants are going to have a golden opportunity to take the lead early in the third period on the power play. Referees conversing in front of the timekeeper's bench. Kyle Chapel, the head coach for the Merchants, having a discussion with a couple of the officials. We are back here in Spruce Grove, Alberta, where we have quite the hockey game between the Merchants and the Regals. After 40 minutes, the score is 3-3, been back and forth. Regals scoring 3 goals in under a minute in that second period. Merchants responded after scoring on a breakaway. So it's anyone's hockey game tonight. Referee takes a tumble. Fans love it. Merchants, 59 points on the year. Regals, only 18 in comparison. However, Regals have an outside chance of making the playoffs still. Opening draw in the third period, controlled by the Spruce Grove Regals. Cross ice pass. Comes back into the defensive zone. Jake Mauger, the captain for the Regals, picks it up. Dishes it up. Landon Koops unable to bring it in, so Regals have to regroup. Some miscommunication by the Regals, forcing them back in their own zone. Here comes Koops, the leading scorer for the Regals. Brought it all the way, shot on net, has denied. Hayden Rake gets it out of the zone. Koops dishes it off. Point to point. Thomas puts it in deep. That's whipped around and it's going to come all the way down on this fresh sheet of ice. Palfrey with a dangerous pass there. Thomas skating for it, picking it up, passing it back. The Eagles look to break out here. That's exactly what they'll do. Partial 3-on-2. That shot attempt goes into the corner in behind the net. Battle for the puck. The Eagles have it. Shot. Rebound. That one just misses. There's some interference there. And some rough stuff away from the play. And finally, the whistle is blown. And we'll see if any penalties have been called here. It's like the only person going towards the sin bin is Hayden Rake. So the Merchants are going to have a golden opportunity to take the lead early in the third period on the power play. Referees conversing in front of the timekeeper's bench. Kyle Chapel, the head coach for the Merchants, having a discussion with a couple of the officials. $110, one bag of groceries at 6-0-7. doesn't seem like the merchants are going to get a call here. Even though the faceoff is coming in the neutral zone. So we're going to play 5-on-5. The only player in the box is for the Regals, but both teams still at even strength. Nevertheless, the merchants bring that over into the offensive zone. Gallo dishes it off to his brother. Gets hit in deep. Laschuk battling hard. Dishing it up to Koops. Koops flips that out. And here come the Regals. Put that up to the far side. Some miscommunication at the blue line. St. Albert nearly giving it away. Puck bouncing around. Saunders on the right wing. Centers it to Gallo. Gallo circling, backhanding it. Puck into the corner. Merchants trying to cycle the puck. Back to the point. Brzozowski, his shot is blocked by Laschuk, and Laschuk just shoots that down. Oh, what a bad pass there. Good stick, shot on net. And Cole Crozier bailing out his team. 3.5 gone in the third period. We are still tied at 3. Faceoff won by the Regals. Shot on net, patted away. Gomez bringing it back in his own zone to find an outlet pass, but it goes on to the stick of Providence. Providence shoots it from distance along the ice. It's saved. Dublin back. Merchants getting hounded by the forecheck of the Regals, but finally able to get it to center ice. Providence, nice pass, backhand to Ayers. His shot goes off a body and over the glass into the netting. Crozier having a discussion with the referee, lobbying for something. Offensive zone draw coming for the Regals. Puck is dropped, put in deep. Merchants get that out with a nice outlet pass. One-handed it in. It's Carlson. Puck goes around to the far corner, back to the point. Rister goes off the stick, over the net, giving Moger an opportunity to flip that up to a racing, oh my goodness, what a race for the puck. Jesse Hiller was on his horse, but he was unable to get it in time. Instead, the puck goes on to Crozier, and Crozier content with getting the whistle. Up to the right of Crozier. Regals able to get it deep. Comes here. Here's a chance from the circle. Oh, high shot. Just into the collarbone of Crozier, and the merchants bring that back on the right side, going the other way. Moger looking for some help there. Puck comes across. It's flipped off the glass and out. 5 minutes gone. Third period. Oh, there's a giveaway. Here's a chance for the Regals. Puck comes to the slot, but merchants bring it back and they have numbers. Up on the left wing. Shot. Shoulder to side by Palfrey. It's flipped out to center ice. Stevenson there for the merchants. He puts it back in the O zone. But it comes back in the other direction. Here's Hayden Rake. Taking the puck in deep. Got hit off of it. And St. Albert unable to clear it, or they are, as it just comes over the blue line. The whistle is blown. So it's been the Gallo boys for the Merchants. The players that have scored, Matteo Gallo and Nico Gallo with two. And for the Regals, thus far it's Cade Cron and Landon Kooch with a pair of goals. There's Katsa for the Merchants, bringing it into the half boards, absorbing a hit, turning, still has the puck. Passes it back to the point, to the far side. Wrister. It somehow gets tipped and it's in. What looked like a harmless wrister initially is tipped in front, and the Merchants regain their lead. Rimstad with the goal. Number 20. Cameron Rimstad makes it a 4-3 game. That goal coming with exactly 6 minutes gone in the set, in the third period. So the Regals playing from behind once again. But the same was, that was the case in the second period, and they were able to respond. Let's see how they respond here. A wraparound chance. That one saved. Comes back to the point. Flung around to the far side. West able to keep it in. Here's a chance right in the middle. Nice save, Palfrey. Anticipating that one. Getting down into the butterfly and denying it. Neutral zone face-off. So face-off to the right of Crozier. Koops. Back to Williams. His shot ripped wide. Puck goes over the net. There's a chance for last chuck. Too many bodies in front. Merchants have some time to get it out. And they're able to. Only to center ice, however. Puck goes back into the offensive zone for the Regals. They look to make something happen. But the Merchants, they collapse. They come back to their own D zone to get that one out. Physical game all night, this one, and it hasn't changed in the third period. Merchants on the attack. Near side. Ficka getting pinned up against the boards. Comes loose, and there's going to be a penalty. For a trip against Cade Cron of the Regals. So with 9:04, Regals have a crucial kill right here. Merchants, you would think if they score here, it will be game, set, match. Shot from the top of the circle. Whistles wide. Gallo back to Saunders. Saunders has to get back. But the Regals playing shorthanded here. You gotta weigh your options if you're the Regals. Do you wanna push for a goal shorthanded or just kill this one off? The Merchants on the left side, and that's cleared away, cleared out, and the St. Albert Merchants, they bring that out of their own zone. over the blue line. Setting up. Chris passed across the ice. Comes back to the point. Rimstad dishes it off. That one goes off the crossbar, rebound. And they score. It's all coming apart here for the Regals. The Merchants scoring three unanswered. This time it's Ketsa. That one comes on the power play. 7:52 remaining in the third period. 6-3 is the score. Oh, there's a giveaway. Providence just rolled off his stick, but here's a chance from behind the net, centering the puck, but unable to do anything with it. And the Merchants bring that back on the left side over the blue line, centering it. Oh, nice blocker save there by Palfrey. Puck up for grabs, goes in behind. Williams just swats that away. Ayers losing the puck. But Maschuk there to back him up, and he brings that out. Put in deep. Good battle. I'd like to see this effort from the Regals, not giving up whatsoever. They've been playing with the Merchants this entire game, keeping them honest. Staying on them physically, staying with them on the scoreboard. But this third period, looks like the Merchants have been the better team. Puck comes back to the point for St. Albert. That one shot up high, blocker to side, and it's flipped out. 6.5 to play. Saunders has it. He passes it right to the middle. Fanning on the puck was Gallo. And comes out. Looks, I think it hit someone on the bench, so the whistle is blown. Puck is dropped. Won by Spruce Grove. Hayden Rake on the far side. Outlet pass. But DePop wasn't able to bring it up. Regals will try it again. Here's DePop. Going to work in the offensive zone. The Merchants. Unable to get this one out. Comes St. Albert. Saunders. Oh, that one just missing. That would have made it 7-3. Regals bring this out. Hard shot right onto the Crozier. Here's tears to the side and comes back into the Regal zone. Dangerous play there. Palfrey covers it up. Face off, won by the Regals. Regals doing decently in the draw all night. Close to about 50-50. What matters is the fact that the score is 6-3 in favor of the Merchants. Merchants playing in the offensive zone here. Comes back to the point. And it's brought out here by Koops. Koops with already two on the night. Holding it, shooting it, and the net comes off. Thank you. we got 4:38 remaining in this third period. A third period that was controlled. It's been controlled by the Merchants. Looks like they'll improve to 33-1 on the year. Unless a miracle happens, but you never know. The Regals did score three in a short period of time in the second period. They'll need something like that to happen again if they want to stay in it. They keep that in the offensive zone. It's a good start, but the Merchants break it out. Over the blue line. Saunders getting hounded and forced out by Jesse Hiller. But St. Albert bring it back the other way. And they shoot it in deep. Stopping it, and behind the net is Palfrey. Monger there to pick it up. And it's chopped out by Koops. And in Koops, his pass, didn't get all of it. Giving the St. Albert Merchants an opportunity to get back in the offensive zone and kill more of this clock. It's cleared out, but no one's there. First of the puck is Koops. It was a set play, but goes right onto Crozier and he covers it up. So it's been a heck of a game here for minor hockey night here at the Grove, the Grant View Arena, Spruce Grove, Alberta. Before the night is out, we got to give thanks to all the kids that came through and all the families from the U9 Bullets, the U7 Oilers, and the U13 Cobras. An excellent turnout here for minor hockey night. That shot goes wide. Battle for it. Goes in deep. Centering the puck. Hayden Rake. Good pick there. To allow the puck to come out. Comes Rimstad. That shot goes over the net. Back to the point with Donald. Over to his D partner. Flipped towards in the general direction of the net, but doesn't make it there. 2:45 to play, third period. Puck goes in deep. Rake, there all by himself, finds Providence. Providence has a chance at the net, unable to put it on. Instead, the puck comes all the way down back into the Regal zone. Providence with a few chances throughout this game to get a goal. Unable to crack the code. The Merchants have it. Oh, nice shot. But even better save by Palfrey. So even though Palfrey has given up six, he's made a massive amount of great saves. Numerous grade A scoring chances he's denied. And there was another one right there. Less than two. Merchants still pressing here. Trying to center it. Instead it comes out in Providence. One on one. Bringing it hard to the paint. Or at least trying to. But gets surrounded by St. Albert Merchants. And here come St. Albert once again. Oh, it's too much sauce on that pass. Or else that would have been a tapping. Pavoski passes it up and goes in deep. Merchants, good battle there to get that one free. And once again, Palfrey staying square. And he's been looking really, really good tonight. We got 78 seconds to play in this hockey game. Face off to the left of Palfrey. It's won by the Regals. Nice saucer pass. From Spruce Grove on the left side. They put it in deep. The Regals go to work. Oh, here's a chance, backhand. Oh, Crozier with a nice save. Good battle effort here. There's a chance, another one. Oh, Crozier somehow saving that one. And a penalty coming up. So, with a late call, Liam Mastrovic getting thrown in the sin bin, and Regals go to their fifth power play of the night. Koops holds that at the point. Tries to find a man on the side of the net. Hiller is right there. It's a good scrum in the corner. Three Regals, couple merchants. Regals come out with it. Looking for another before the time runs out. Puck comes back to the Mauger. He's shot. Rebound on the side of the net. Crozier able to find it and cover it up. And here we go. Tempers finally blowing over here. You just knew there would be some of that in a tight game like this. Only 23 seconds remain. And the beacon continues. Both those players will hit the showers early. So all in all, the Regals played the Merchants physically. They scored three goals in less than a minute in the second period. They stayed with them up until this third, but they're not giving up. That shot, blockered up over the glass. Face off to the left of Crozier. Won by the Merchants, but the Regals picked that up, they center it, and that one is eventually cleared just past the blue line. Here comes Mauger. He gets tripped, but it's not going to mean much as the buzzer is about to sound. Only 3.7 remains. Take this time to reiterate the goal scores. For the Regals tonight, Cade Cron, Landon Koops with two. Koops looking terrific, scoring his 33rd and 34th of the year. And for the Merchants, their goal scorers, Matteo Gallo, Hudson Ketsa, Tyler Ficca, Nico Gallo, and Cameron Rimstad. Nico Gallo had two. And that will do it for this hockey game at the Grand Fury Arena for Minor Hockey Night. The St. Albert Merchants improved to 30-30-1 on the year. Regals fall to 8-25-2. We thank you for joining us. On behalf of the CJHL and the Spruce Grove Regals, my name is Josh Jacko. See you next time.